When reviewing apps submitted to the App Directory, one of the key things we look out for are scope requests. Scopes are what give your app certain access and permissions within a given workspace. Therefore, appropriate scope usage determines whether your app is secure for Slack users. During the app review process, there are three common mistakes that we see when developers request scopes. Not providing adequate reasoning for the scopes you're requesting. Requesting too many scopes or scopes that are too broad for your app's functionality. And three, assigning scopes to your user token instead of your bot token. For context, when we're reviewing apps, we compare the requested scopes directly with the functionality of your app. If we notice the scope does not pair up with what your app is meant to do, we will flag that. We also compare the scopes that are requested to the scopes that appear during the OAuth submission flow. If there are any discrepancies there, we will also flag that. A good way to avoid these issues is to conduct a thorough audit of all the scopes you are requesting and all the endpoints your app is calling. You can check your code, for example. What endpoints or what methods is your app calling in your code? Make sure that all the scopes you're requesting directly match up with the endpoints that your app is calling. If there are scopes that don't directly call a specific method within your app, then you probably don't need that scope. Another thing to note is history scopes. They tend to be pretty broad and send out a lot of information. So before you request a history scope, make sure you've tested out all other positive alternatives. If you absolutely need to request a history scope, make sure you associate it to your bot token. This brings me to my last point. Before even requesting scopes, make sure you really understand the difference between a bot token and a user token. The Slack API uses the granular bot permissions model, which centers around the bot token. The bot token should generally always be used unless for some reason, very specific functionality can only be achieved via the user token. So before assigning scopes to the user token, make sure you've tested it out with the bot token first and can strongly justify the use of a user token scope. For more information about the granular bot permission model and the general differences between the user token and the bot token, make sure you watch the video linked below.